spoke with several women today who were too fearful to be interviewed about this subject, but my next guest is not one of them. Iman Al-Nafjan is a teacher and PhD student in Riyadh who writes a blog under the name Saudi Woman. Like many in Saudi Arabia, she too has a driver. She joins me now on the phone. First, your reaction to Manal's story.
I feel bad for Manal, and I don't think that she should be in prison. She didn't do anything. We were a country based on Islam, and she didn't do anything against Islam by driving. When she drove with her brother, and she was decently dressed, and there's nothing in Islam that says she can't do that.
Would the majority of men, do you think, really object to women driving in Saudi Arabia?
Actually, I don't believe so. Maybe 20 years ago, yes, when the first protest began. But now, things have changed. The economy has changed. People have opened their eyes to the rest of the world. The mentalities have changed. I think that most Saudis would, men and women.
Listen.
Most would be able to have women drive.
Listening to the King in Atika's report there, being interviewed by Barbara Walters, you'd be forgiven for being confused. He says a day will come when women will drive in Saudi. Do you believe that?
I remember when it was first shown, the interview, there was a lot of hope and optimism. People were talking about it, and they were saying, oh, the decision is going to come, we're just waiting for the announcement. And then we waited 1 year, a second year, and it just didn't come.
Documents given to WikiLeaks earlier show that the Obama administration actually pushed Saudis to give female citizens more rights. When you heard Obama's speech last week, talking about lauding the rights of women, but making absolutely no reference to Saudi Arabia, nor to human rights there, or the denial of rights for anybody, what did you think?
I didn't think anything. I mean, we live in a global community, and supporting each other is part of that. But really, I believe this is an internal issue that needs to be resolved internally. Giving it media attention might help it come up, you know, rise up to the top, and that's good. But no outside forces will be able to resolve this. This is something for the Saudis.
Iman, we absolutely appreciate you being with us this evening and listening to your words. You're making a lot of sense. Thank you for that.